Hey guys, welcome back to Face the TV. We are here. Usually, if we finish so early as we did today at around 7-ish, we tend to do show matches and stuff like that. But today, we decided that we had such an awesome match in the quarterfinals that we would show that match to you guys as a demo cast. We're going to cast the demo of it because I imagine a lot of you guys didn't see it. So, we can just go. Let's start it. I'll start it. I have a playlist of all the demos. Faz played against Cypher. And if you weren't here earlier, there was, I won't spoil it if you don't know roughly what's going to happen.
You'll see. Faz versus Cypher.
We're getting the countdown underway here on this demo. And it is Furious Heights, which is the first map between these two to begin with. And here we go. We're in the game. And you can see we're going to be on Faz's POV the entire
time. Even though
it
says Cypher there on the top left, it's like, Faz's POV.
Exactly.
Look at the plasma right off the start. He's even going to get, he doesn't get the kill, but he knows he left Cypher low. So I guess he's going to go fairly aggressive now. Well, he doesn't. Is he gonna try to defend this red armor though?
I don't know. He has the railgun there. He does hit a beautiful railgun to Cypher, and Cypher's gonna be dodging and juking and driving. Oh my god, he manages to connect that. Very nice there from Faz.
So now he knows that the mag is gonna spawn in a couple of seconds. Oh, doesn't manage to eat that rail, which should have given him a major advantage at that mag. Let's see how he's gonna pull this rail. Did Cypher get it? I didn't really know.
My god, Faz.
This means
chill,
Cypher
man.
Didn't get the mega yet.
Faz needs to chill. Oh! We have to. I'll time the items.
You'll time the items.
Yeah.
I'll do everything else.
Okay. I'll time the items. There's red. Alright. The next red at 20. Okay, good.
Mega's up though. Oh, it should be up.
Well, it should be up for another 15 seconds at least. Depends if it was delayed on the spawn. But there is Cypher gunning down Faz. Faz was in that mega rare, like, kind of way before it's going to spawn. Mega should be in the next 5 seconds if it's at a normal time, and Faz is just getting completely destroyed there. Oh my god, off the spawn. Cypher just not letting up at all with the railgun. He's just being a complete beast there. And Faz is going to try to stand on the red even to steal it, but nothing. And Cypher just crushes him again. So he falls back onto the yellow armor, and the red was just taken at 20. So this is going to be the next one for 45 or so. And so that means there's not much around for Faz at the moment. He's just got to try to survive, and Cypher knows
he can't survive. With Cypher being so aggressive because he knows he has clear advantage. Here comes Cypher. How much damage can Faz do?
Not very much, it seems like, and now he's risking death here, jumping across. And he dies. Beautiful raining from Cypher. We can see he's hitting 60%. Mega should be now. Mega should basically be now. I haven't seen a direct time on it just yet.
The red is now as well, so Faz maybe. Can he delay Cypher? No, he's gonna die again. I think. Yep, there he is. Cypher is still on 70% rail.
So red, I think, should be around 10. So Faz hasn't seen it taken since before, and it was. So it should be around 10-ish, I guess, unless Cypher delayed it. And no. Ouch.
Good rail. He's one more, he can take the red. Another good one. Rail, he gets the red.
Okay, red.
So the red's
okay,
at 40.
Yeah.
There we go. Oh, what the, look at Cypher, he's
hitting everything, man.
It's so frustrating.
I haven't seen this kind of. Like, Faz has been on the end. I don't know, it must be just Faz today. Because when he's playing against Ash as well, Ash is just hitting 80% rail. So, okay, GG. And there you go, good trap there from Faz. Connecting a lot of LG onto Cypher. Does get him down. Oh, taking. Does get a rail though.
At 5.
So there's another rail onto Cypher. See how you like it, Cypher. And we have Mega spawning
still
in around 15 seconds. Or Mega should be. We haven't seen from Faz's POV exactly when it is, but it should be around 15 seconds. So like 3:10 ish, probably.
Probably Cypher is getting the Mega right now, so I guess it will spawn at 25.
Let's see, it's so hard to know when you have the timer and we haven't seen it taken. So I mean, you can just get an insight into Faz's position. He's trying to estimate when it will be, but really he just has no idea. But he does get the red at least. He gets himself over to Mega. I don't think it's spawned yet. Faz, a Cypher jump, something across for it. And did he take it there or not? I'm not sure. I guess he took it. So about 3:15, so that's more or less the prediction. So 50 the next.
The red's going to be up in 2 seconds. Faz knows he wants to make a move onto it. Where is Cypher? This is too quiet now for Faz. He gets the red at 30, so he's gonna spawn at 55, but both make the right spawning at the same time.
50 and 55, so this is gonna be pretty tense. I mean, Mega's gonna be first, it's gonna be the priority here. But if Faz wants to play it safe, he can try to delay Cypher by about 5 seconds by just being in this position, trying to shoot up. And actually, Cypher's gonna go straight for the red armor.
This tells Faz that he can just take everything.
This is a mistime, yeah, this was a mistime. It's 50 and 55 in the order of Mega Red.
Yeah, so Faz, he got that red, he's gonna spawn at 22, and when does he want the Mega to spawn? Mega's gonna spawn at 42. 22 and 42, 10 seconds for the red. Where is Cypher's? Faz wants to do damage on Cypher. maybe even kill him before the Red spawns. He hears him. This is the rail. And Red's gonna be up. He needs to delay the Red a little bit, the Mega a little bit. Time now he can take it.
Yeah.
51.
So it's going well for Faz now. But he wants to get himself back onto the Mega. And he even sees the yellow up, so Cypher's kind of like... I think Cypher's been making some errors here. I think he should have been able to at least take that. And there's the Mega. It's the next Mega on 19. And
the Red's going to be up in 2 seconds. Missed the rail. But look at this. Cypher is being a ninja, as we all know it can be. 73 for like 2 minutes. Oh, he just switches away.
The classic. Okay, so 19 and 25 now. So 19 the Mega, 25 the Red. So Faz wants to already set himself up with some good position on this Mega health, and he has enough seconds interval to get to the Red in time, but he's got to be quick. So here's Mega now, 19. He needs to take it immediately. He's actually going to drop straight. For Cypher, this is a good decision because he's already got a great stack.
Yeah, but
now that's a problem.
Yeah.
Should have committed to Red.
If he starts committing, yeah, he has to commit to the end. But luckily for him, Cypher is no.
Yeah, he didn't know.
He's not in a position that he can actually do aggressive moves just yet. He likes his lead too much. He doesn't want to go for aggressive moves. Cypher probably has around 150 armor right now, and Faz cannot catch him off guard. Cypher, it's so hard to catch him.
So it should be something like 55 reds and on the minute for Mega, I think. So here it is. It goes aggressive, finds Cypher. I mean, oh,
Cypher just running away. Where is he?
There's a red 55. So
21.
And then now Mega on the minute. There it is.
21 and 36.
Okay, so this is plays in Faz's favor to have such a separation between those two big ones, big items. It really prevents the delaying strategy from Cypher, should you want to make that. And make his way to Reds. Here we go. Into Red he goes. No trap, close range. You can see just yet. Cypher, probably the yellow. No, where is Cypher? He's going to be chilling somewhere.
It's going to be 48. The Mega's going to spawn in a couple of seconds. And Cypher. There he is. But look at how much time did Cypher waste already?
Yeah, strange.
About 3 minutes, because Faz is too busy controlling the items. There he goes, gets a good ring.
Oh my god.
Cypher just drone a bridge there.
Yeah.
Faz just walked in Cypher's LG there.
Yeah, drone a bridge, I like it.
Erected
a bridge. It's like worms with the girder, yeah. You can place a girder.
Imagine if Cypher had stopped to shoot LG for a second, just so Faz wouldn't be on that level height, and then he would fall, and then that would. You just get the kill, but you don't want to fall when you're hitting 100. You want to stop.
And it's like Faz goes down.
Classic Cypher move. I mean, 4 seconds, 4 minutes out of control. He gets a good situation. He takes the lead again.
Yeah, he's just playing for those efficient damage dealing spots and seeing where.
Wow!
It gets it. Whoa!
Oh, where? The amazing bounce there. What can Faz do?
Oh no!
If we were watching this on stream, we'd probably call him GG by now. Look at the damage. So much damage with the plasma. Is he gonna kill him? No, not yet. But he knows that Cypher doesn't have that much stack right now. He probably has around 30 health and around 150 armor. Maybe even 50 health because of 25s.
What? Cypher into the LG of Faz.
There goes Cypher.
Yeah, boom, dead. So that's 6 frags now.
That was a very weird rocket jump.
Yeah. Pretty high in it as well, like not even a flat one, which he needed. Okay, there's the red pickup for Faz. Next red on.
4.
Yeah.
And he knows that Cypher just got the Mega. So Mega should be spawning at 15.
Here he goes onto the Mega, spots Cypher. Cypher has a good position there to escape easily but deal some damage. Cypher always putting himself in those spots.
1 minute to go, 6 frags to make up for. How can he make this happen? Good rocket, another good rocket.
And Cypher's gonna die. Faz has to shoot. Oh my god, that flit rail. Beautiful, and again, just plucks him out of the air with that railgun as he now picks up the Mega health. There it is. And that means 24 for the next one.
And 10 for the red, I think.
And find Cypher again.
Four frags to make up for. 1 minute is totally possible right now.
Oh, the destruct pillar.
Oh, so much damage there. And the red's gonna be up. Cypher just stole the red.
But Faz still has a lot of armor left. He didn't take any damage.
Yeah, but the red's gonna spawn at 31. Mac is gonna be spawning fairly soon.
And Faz is trying to just catch him.
Yeah, where is Cypher?
Oh, he hears him. Oh, beautiful trap from Faz. Oh my god. He's gonna get a high tether over to the Mega though if he wants it.
What?
What? Awesome.
What are the
Not again. I've never seen that happen twice in a row.
Cypher the Mega though. And he knows he has 30 seconds to make up for one frag.
Oh, but he denies the LG.
Oh, comes back up.
Denies the LG. And he gets the kill. Ties the game. And 20 seconds left. It's too easy. His name's Faz. The power of Pele. The power of Pele Soderman.
The red's gonna spawn in 2 seconds. Faz is nowhere near. Here he comes. Can he do damage? There he goes. It's a little bit of damage. It's the second rail, so we're going into the first overtime.
Overtime. Rail. Easy. Mega.
And now
easier.
He knows when the red spawns in, he knows yes.
43 on
full
the Mega.
Advantage. Where is Cypher? No Cypher to be seen. I wonder for how long will Cypher be able to play like a ninja again? I guess that's... Oh, wow. Great rail.
These rails. Faz high fives the Destruct Pillar as he jumps by. What's up, man? And... Oh, what an angle. Mega's coming up now, though.
Yeah.
42 or something. 43 it was.
Yeah, but...
Come on, Faz. 43.
The red is spawning at 46. Can he get there on time? I don't think Cypher will be there, so he'll probably get it.
17 next Mega. And there's the creep from Faz. Again, this trapping has been...
Mega's like at 17, but the red is going to be up at 21. It's fairly close between both items, but Cypher's playing like this. I don't think Cypher will actually try to jump for him.
Oh!
What? What is this?
Are you serious? Are you serious?
I have the stream right open and I saw it again and I still can't believe he hit that.
Oh my god.
It just doesn't make any sense.
Okay, whatever. Okay. 54 next Mega. And Faz, I mean the game's still tied, but Faz is just hitting models that aren't there. Hitting ghosts. Maybe it's like the ghost of Cypher from the past or something. He traveled in time there or something with his railgun. I don't know. But he is in a very dominant position at the moment. And the items are coming up soon. There's Zeored.
And if anyone wants to know, we cannot change path as this is Faz's demo.
Yeah. So if I press anything, the demo ends.
Exactly.
If I press anything.
Oh, great damage on Cypher, but he's going to go to another overtime. And maybe now he can get the frag right in the... There we go, he's going to get the frag.
He even like times out after in the midair. Boom, dead. So there is the frag. Probably seeing the demo, like Inz is connected to the server in a second, because this is kind of the point that you came in when
you were
trying to figure out what's happening. Oh my god, Faz! Faz! Why is it good? Why is it good? Is it hard being so good? Seems like he's making it look easy.
After about 10 minutes or 8 minutes out of control, how would the Cypher get back onto the item?
It's very difficult as well. I mean, Faz has been connecting so much damage for free that he's always very stacked, and Cypher's never able to show himself to contest anything. And I think Mega's on 8 or 9, and so there's plenty of time here for Faz to have. He can even reposition if he wants, but it's like Cypher's gonna reposition into Faz's face, and that's actually gonna force Faz back onto the red. But Faz is happy. He knows he just has 50 seconds to kill now, and he wins this game.
Oh, there
is connected. Man, and here it is.
Faz just needs to run now. He doesn't need to do anything else.
Yeah, this is a pretty damn awesome game. And this is just one map. Oh, wow.
And the rail after that just secures the game for Faz and Cypher.
This must
come in anymore.
Have been quite raging for Cypher.
Yeah. I mean, some of the rails that Faz hit were ridiculous.
And off the spawn as well. That was pretty nice, the combo.
Good weapon decision there.
Yeah. Very nice. GG's exchanged. Faz wins after an awesome comeback, many cool frags, and an invisible rail hits, or a hit onto an invisible Cypher. We found the invisibility power up, or something like that. We need to see that rail again. Like,
that was some sick rail.
Because we couldn't even see him. anywhere.
We couldn't see anything.
Like, it's not like Faz saw him disappearing around the corner. It was just nothing.
I think maybe you're there, so I'll shoot him. Boom.
Yeah. There you go. Faz gets the Mega Spawn.
This is the second map.
I don't think this is... I think this is the... Yeah, the third map is also a crazy one, but I think this is... I don't know what to expect. I didn't hear anything about this map.
Let's see. Faz got arguably the better spawn as he's well positioned.
Oh, yeah. He just misses the LG, but this is something he can remedy. But he's the only thing, the only deficit of this orb.
He goes. Oh, it comes a bit delayed. The damage.
Yes, no, yes, no. Push him in the lava. No.
The damage from Cypher was way too much. I mean, Faz was connecting good rocks, but the damage from Cypher is just excruciating.
Oh,
wow.
Oh. Just a flick, just to make the jump and then flick back. Love it. But yeah, I mean, it was so close for him to actually be pushing, or rather, when you get Cypher in the lava once, he's stuck there and he's going to die for sure. But Cypher barely managed to avoid that. And now it's 1-1 in a minute. This seems like it was so far like the best match of the tournament.
Yeah.
I mean, we didn't stream it, but it's okay, we got the demos. Faz's perspective. We have to time items ourselves, which I always like for some reason.
Well, in this map, we don't really need to time much items because this map is fairly positional. Yeah. Oh, I don't know what Cypher went to do there, but he's back up to his corner.
Fake rocket jump. No double back. Cypher not falling for it. I swear people never fall for it. And I don't know, and I swear that people never know that it's the fake rocket jump. It's just how it happens. It's so strange sometimes. Mega's now is 45. So, oh wow.
Almost bounces fast to the lava there.
I love, and this is what, in this matter about positional, Mega's been up for like a good 5 seconds now, but Faz knows he can see the way that yellow, he knows that he's able to cut off Cypher's position.
He's like seeing the Matrix now, he's not seeing the map like we are, he's like seeing what items are up, the possible routes for Cypher, and the order of the items. There's another fake rocket jump, but I don't think Cypher will fall for it.
He should keep doing it, eventually it'll work.
Once will work.
Yeah, then it's worth it. 31 is the next Mega, and Faz is creeping and crawling.
He's fazzing around the map.
And he Where hasn't got much time left.
He finally gets an LG after 2 minutes of game.
And he's basically done. Mega is spawning now.
He goes for the red, that might be a mistake.
Yeah.
Now he's going to check on the Mega. Cypher just got the Mega. That's where the mistake went.
This is a huge mistake because if you're the player out of control, you're taking the Mega.
Look how he remedied it.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. Not too bad. Not too bad.
But I mean, unless you are guaranteed to lose that kind of damage, don't miss out on one of the items. If anything, leave the red up because you can do a lot of damage when players go for the red.
Exactly. And not to mention, if Cypher's scared that he has a stack deficit, he's not taking a fight in the open area, which is a red fight. He's going to take a fight in close quarters. How does he do that? By going for Mega. So his option, best option is Mega. So if you have a choice between red and Mega in that spot, I'm always choosing go to take and win the Mega.
Yeah.
And then, like you said, the position of red is so bad that you can damage them. But nevertheless, Faz, you know, he's doing okay. Got himself an armor up.
Warping around that corner. Oh, spot Cypher there. Cypher is still there. Some damage.
And you can see Faz controlling this outside area.
Yeah, but Cypher, he will not die. I've seen him play with this map versus Cooler with someone that actually strangles your opponent just out of their control. And Cypher is like, I'm not giving a frag up. I can just play this map without control for an infinite amount of time. I mean, look at the damage just hit on fast.
Yeah, that was really, really nice.
Isn't the Mega up right now?
It should be, yeah. I'm pretty certain it is.
And Cypher going for it.
That splash could have been really nice.
He took the Mega, so the Mega probably spawns at 43 now.
Man, I love... Faz has so many smart rockets.
Yeah, I mean, Cypher took the Mega, and Faz just did damage back to him.
Yeah.
So, like, Cypher has to creep on the ramp again. Faz wants to deny that 50 just to make sure Cypher will not go.
Oh, Mega.
Oh, Mega is up now, so Cypher did not take it.
6 on the next Mega. Oh, and he catches the drop from Cypher. He was going to make him
be frag.
His way onto the red. And there you go. That was, beautiful.
No,
really,
but he still died. He should not have been so aggressive there. He need to make sure he was the one that had the first little bit of LG.
Yeah. And now, with Mega coming up at 6, I think it was. He has a good spot for it, but the thing is he hasn't got anything but shotgun, so this is risky if Cypher goes for it. Ooh, missed time.
Cypher doesn't know the Mega timing. He's not creeping around. Try checking. Is Fez
steal
it? He's gonna steal it, but at what cost? He's doing good damage on Cypher.
Oh man, he's gotta be so low. How low is he? Oh, he's gonna go around the back! Oh my god!
So crazy!
That could have worked. It's so close to working.
Yeah, but that's so risky.
I love that though. That's amazing.
He didn't really have anything to lose at that point, so besides a frag.
And the thing is that he spawns, and look at what he gets off the spawn. So like you can see, like by understanding when it's okay to die, you can make like what he did was make a really risky play. But he's like, if I die here, it's fine because I spawn on the rocket yellow and
LG. He didn't
LG.
Do the best decision off the spawn as well. He's gonna get the mega.
Yeah.
Can he do damage on Cypher? Here he is. Oh, Cypher. Knowing where Fez is, Rocket jumps away.
And there is the shotgun action again. But Cypher's 3 frags in the lead with 4 minutes left now. It's not looking super good for Fez. But he goes in! Fez goes in! And he gets the kill.
Right before the red spawn. That's perfect timing right there. When you have the timing, those are the kind of moves you need to make.
Yeah, sometimes he's very unpredictable, is Fez. And makes his shots up on to the sky. The realm of Cypher.
Mega spawning at the minute. Red spawning 5 or 6 seconds. But he's like, I'm not dropping for the red unless you are.
This is the first time he's done a trap here.
Oh, in Cypher,
yeah. Gets it wrong. That trap, unfortunately, for Fez. 2 frags though, this is really close. Keeping the Swedish hope alive. And creeping, crawling back onto the Mega. And grabs it. So 36 and Ace Mega. Doesn't he? Ah, okay, there it is. Picks up the LG cells. This is basically his last chance to really make his comeback in the game.
Yeah, just the next frag needs to be fairly clean as well. Unless you want Cypher to keep running away. Like, the Mega is about to spawn, so that's the perfect time to get a fight. Can he do enough damage? He needs to go in, because if he doesn't, Cypher will go away, and steal that Mega. Look at the damage from Cypher. How does he even do that much damage to Cypher?
1 second for a spawn.
This is why he's Cypher.
Yes.
It doesn't. It's even impossible to know where does all that damage come from.
Yeah. And he calls it GG, and we move on to map number 3. Gotta love the playlist.
Yeah.
Demo playlist.
Pretty cool.
Thank you, QL Prism developers.
3, 2.
And also thank you, QL Prism developers, for implementing some FaceIt stuff on your on the GUI. The graphical user interface, whatever you want to call it. But there you go, off to start there. Taking a nasty rail. Faz does make his way onto damage from Cypher. Cypher can't respond with anything but with rail, but he does hit the 2 rails. Oh, splash, splash, but
who's gonna be the first to get to 225?
Ah, what? Oh, an angle. Oh, he spawns
there. What? How crazy is that?
That's no way. Oh, God.
Cypher must be so annoyed by now.
Oh, he didn't even go to deny the 25s in the end, but yeah. And
he's gonna get the Mega now, and Cypher, even though he got the first frag, is out of control again. We've seen Cypher out of control for most of this entire best of 3.
He lives there. He lives without control. And the rocket jump up is the classic from Faz. Classic move. And
he can't really anger around.
Yeah. Faz knows. Did way too well there.
Knows exactly when to back away. And now if he gets the yellow and does more damage. Just needs to drop to the yellow. The Mega's gonna be up now.
Yeah.
But look at the damage from Cypher. He just keeps making sure he knows Faz's whereabouts. More damage again. Even the T-ball connects to the server.
44 on the Mega. And let's see when. What the red status is like. Is red up on the spot? Yeah, it is. And 44 for next Mega. I mean, or was it 54?
Look at the stack 54. Of Faz. He's going for it, but he's left very crippled.
Mega in 8 seconds.
And Cypher. Yeah, Faz just can't hang around for it.
Yeah,
Cypher eating 44 LG and 60% rail. Okay. What is that?
He sees when Cypher picks up the Negra at the very least. So next one on 30 or 29, I think.
Oh, oh my god, a prediction from Cypher. Sickening.
Hello. And there you go. Here comes Faz for some rockets. Try and damage, as Cypher picks up that red, but doesn't get anything. Cypher not giving him anything. Is able to steal away yellow though, and
Mega spawning in 6 seconds. Is Faz gonna take the grenade position or just, yeah, gonna try to rail?
And Mega spawns.
And Faz probably away. Taken. I guess he's gonna try to estimate.
Yeah, should be 5. Is what Faz is thinking.
Yeah, he goes back there, gets the LG, and now he knows the Mega has to spawn between 5 and 15. So it's probably gonna be at 5 or 6.
Yeah, exactly. So there comes Cypher with a lot of damage again, and that rail is just gonna, it's like, yeah, you're off the map now for like a good another minute, see ya. And there's the Mega spawning on 5, probably.
I mean, the way that Cypher does damage is one of his good rocket, and the Mega is up.
Yeah.
He needs to back away to the Mega right now, but Cypher is more faster. He's faster than Faz there.
If Faz reacted instantly, it's possible, but he would probably have died in the process.
Yeah, because if he went through that doorway, Cypher would be there. Nice steal on the red, and the good rail. But he's railable. What can he do now? Is he going to wait for a 25? Maybe. Is Cypher still there? No. No Cypher to be seen, so he can go and take the leg, that top yellow armor. But look how Faz has been playing.
Faz has to back away, 13 health. And time is ticking, but still. 6 minutes left in this game. Goes to the next red as well. Cypher getting that one up. Where was Cypher?
There he is. Oh. Doesn't even take them. Oh, what? How did Cypher connect with the rail and Faz didn't?
So when is the Mega? Because Faz hasn't seen it in a while. And
yeah, we have no idea. From Faz's buff.
The last one should have been 340-ish. So
maybe in
the
like
estimate should be 415 to 425.
Exactly. So you should know, like, Cypher's not going to drop to the Mega until he gets the red. So Faz maybe can trick his way around to get one of them.
Yes,
whoa, great,
that's
damage.
It. Perfect.
Can he go aggressive there? Can he try to do damage at the Mega?
And now you can see when Mega's picked up. Okay, yeah. He knows now.
Mega's going to be up at 59 or around that.
And that helps him. So,
and now he has position on the red, which is even more important. There he goes. Ooh, that was even not enough.
Yeah, that was risky.
Can he still go to try to get the red? Oh, Cypher just
and
steals
Mega's
the red.
Mega's now, he's going to try to defend this spot. 55-ish.
Look at the damage from Cypher. Cypher can just come in with the LG.
No. Where is Mega?
There we go.
Oh, one. Okay, whoa. Okay, 36
there.
Now he knows for sure.
The red is up in 5 seconds. Can Faz go for it?
He's looking for it. The damage again on Cypher as he rocket jumps up. He's trying to be so sly. Does get two rails. He's going for more. That is very ballsy. But he wanted to get that yellow. Like, he wanted to risk it all. So he could get that yellow and then circle back around for the upper yellow, which gives him a much, much faster 100-100.
Mega's gonna be up now. He needs to make sure he knows the time. Oh, he just saw Cypher creeping around there, so he knows that Cypher is gonna get that Mega.
Oh, maybe not.
Cypher didn't get the Mega. Cypher was too slow.
Man, Faz, I love that series of plays there. That was really amazing.
Now he goes for the Mega. And he delayed it even a little bit by going to the red first. So Cypher has no idea. Or so we think.
And not the perfect LG, but it's enough.
Yeah, and as long as you keep dodging.
It keeps up enough stack there to push things forwards.
So the red is going to be the next item up. And Mega is going to be up 5 or 6 seconds after the red. Or even more, 12 seconds after the red. Yeah.
There you go, red.
8 seconds for the Mega. 7, 6, I wonder if I'm correct. 4, 3, 2, yeah. Almost correct.
So 59 then, for the next Mega.
Yeah, and the red's gonna spawn at 40.
He's just waiting. And he does catch Cypher quite a lot with the waiting on the lower spots of the map. And there is Cypher again. And the jump up to the red. Yields him another juicy 100.
Oh, I find Cypher. It's gonna be a frag. There we go. 2 frags to make up for. Still 3 minutes to go. We can just try to strangle Cypher, but how many people can actually strangle Cypher?
I don't know the answer to that one.
Probably no one.
I like to think that Unkind could do it if Unkind is still here playing.
He still
Quake.
Plays, you know.
No, he doesn't.
He does.
No.
He does, with a fake account.
Lies, I don't believe it.
But he barely plays.
You have to, if you show me one demo, I can tell you if it's Unkind or not.
After 10 years, will you still recognize him?
Oh yeah, he had the most distinctive style in the world. So we're on 2.5 minutes left. It's a 2-frag game. And Faz's stack is pretty awesome. Pretty awesome. He's going to jump up. There it, oh, he misses
almost
it.
Almost rocket jumps
up. But does that works in his favor, though, so he actually gets the mega.
Yeah, if he rocket jumped up, Cypher could have tricked his way around to get the mega.
Exactly.
Look at this. So sneaky. He tried to get the red, but also protecting that top yellow. Can he get the top yellow? No.
Oh, okay. He's going to get a lot of damage before Cypher picks it up. There it is.
What? Wow. How does Cypher even win that?
I mean,
that's Cypher. You just don't expect him to win the fights that he does.
He's going to trap the 25s. Cypher coming. Oh, Cypher does go. But
oh, but what? That is sickening. The reactions from Cypher are just ridiculous.
Okay, 2 minutes left. 4 frags now.
I would call it GG by now.
Yeah, you would.
I don't know. Look, I mean, it's even more GG by now.
What?
If Fat is to bring this back, how is he gonna do it?
Yeah, we're gonna find out. A minute and a half left. Here comes some rockets. There's one, there's two.
There's the next one.
Oh, wow! What? And the rocket, that last rocket did like 80 damage, and then Cypher's like, what? And then the machine gun. That's all he needed. So still 4 frags though in a minute.
Oh, wow!
Oh, he pushed him off!
That never happened before. How do you push someone off with a rail?
Yeah, from that angle, you push them sideways.
The rail must have hit him in his right arm or something.
Oh, mid-air rocket. Another beautiful rocket from Cypher. Bacon's comes fast around the corner.
Oh, misses the rail.
Is he lagging?
A little bit,
happening?
How are Swedish internet lagging?
He's got 3 frags left in 40 seconds.
I'm just waiting to see amazing shots now. 40 seconds versus Cypher. Nobody can. Nobody will say this.
Oh my god.
Wow.
How does Faz do it? There is one. Come on.
25 seconds, 3 frags. Oh
my god. What a beast. He's loving it.
He's like, I don't even want to play anymore. I'm just going to laugh.
And the double back. He does this a lot against Cypher. It works always versus Cypher. Faz is so good at reading Cypher. He knows how he thinks.
20 seconds remaining. He hears Cypher. Where is he? Is he going to wait for Cypher to double back again?
He's walking. This is it. By walking here, you're committing that your read is correct, pretty much. And actually, in the last second, he's like, uh-oh, Cypher's not there.
Where is Cypher?
I have no time. Where is
Cypher?
He finds him at the jump pad. Cypher goes down. And that is tight game in overtime. And Cypher's like, what?
How is this even happening? I don't believe the way Faz brought back.
Yeah.
Yeah. It just doesn't make any sense.
It's so awesome. Not only the rockets to machine gun, but then that rail that like pushed Cypher over sideways. How?
I don't know. Maybe
it looks so weird.
Hit him on his arm and he's like, whoa. And I don't know. I don't get it.
This is freaking awesome. Oh my god. Cypher. What happened, man? Okay, so Faz has got a really huge stack now. I mean, it's still doable for
Cypher. At least the Mega, because he knows Cypher had to back off. And now here he comes. Mega is about to spawn. Where is Cypher? Can Cypher even come near the Mega? He probably only has 1 yellow to play with. Maybe he has 75 armor, not more than that. There goes all of Cypher's armor, and it's gonna be... This has to be a frag for Faz.
Yep, and Faz. Oh, beautiful rocket there. Straight into Cypher. And that's the kill. I mean, Faz is a guy that does a lot of unconventional stuff, and he's unpredictable, but the decisions he makes are weighed pretty well. I think one of the coolest decisions he made in this game to me was when he took the rail fight at the shotgun and, like, basically risked getting hit and dying versus getting both yellows really fast.
Yeah.
And then those yellows gave him the challenge on the Mega, which
exactly.
He then won.
Which had such a big payout that you just really want to go for it.
It was really, 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 really smart.
30 seconds now, and Cypher is thinking of a way to come back, and he just... Can he do it? Because Cypher
should, at this point, Cypher should be just like, yeah, man, you can just have this one. Like,
I don't
just
want
have this
to play
one.
With you anymore.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you earned it. You can just have it.
Here he comes, and now he doesn't have any stack to fight Faz with.
Yeah, and actually Faz has lost a lot of his stack. But that's it, time is gone, and they call GG, and good games indeed, and that's going to be... Nice Faz, well played. That was pretty damn awesome. Pretty damn awesome series that was. Whoa. So, yeah. So we're going to go for a break, guys. I hope you enjoyed that demo. And we will be back with the North American Cup after this.